You know how you always have that one person on the team who wants to use Google Sheets instead of a database? Okay, let's be honest. It's the CEO who calls themselves a technical founder because they made that pivot table in Excel that one time. Anyway, they're the boss, so let's make it work with foreign data wrappers. This is where we can use our Postgres database as a single interface for all of our data, even if it lives somewhere outside our database, like
Google Sheets.
We can combine this external data with other tables in our database and pretend it's all in one convenient location. You know, like if we had designed that schema properly from the start. But we really want that raise, so let's get into it. Here we have the docs for Postgres wrappers. So this is a Rust framework for developing Postgres foreign data wrappers. And you can find this at fdw.dev or just click that link down in the description. But this has a whole bunch of helpful information about why we've built this, and under Guides and Quick Start, you'll see a bunch of prerequisites which you'll need to install, as well as this template on GitHub to get started. So we're going to fork this one, and we can leave all of the defaults and click Create Fork, and then under Code, we can grab this URL and open up our terminal and use the git CLI to clone that URL. We can then change into that directory and open it up in VS Code. And we can see our template project with no package.json. Okay, before we get too overwhelmed by that, let's go and create our Google Sheet and put some data in it that we want to pull into our Postgres database. So over at sheets.google.com, we want to create a blank spreadsheet, and we can get rid of all of this stuff and give it a name like products. So this is going to be the CEO's database where they can add products that we sell from our e-commerce app. So let's add some headings for SKU and then the name of each of our products and a price for how much they cost. Now let's populate this with some example data. And so we're selling two products, a t-shirt and a keyboard. Now to make this available from Google APIs, we can click share and under general access, change this from restricted to anyone with the link and then copy the link for this specific spreadsheet. And now if we make a request to this URL, so I'm going to use the Thunder client extension in VS Code. So this will send a get request to the URL of our spreadsheet. And then if we get rid of this slash edit bit and replace it with slash gviz and then slash tq question mark tqx equals out colon json and click send to make that HTTP request, we'll see we get back this response, which has a collection of rows containing our fields for our SKU, our name, and our price. So this is giving us all of the data from our spreadsheet in a nice or kind of nice JSON format. So let's wrap up this HTTP request in a foreign data wrapper so we can treat it like any old data in our Postgres database and combine it with the rest of our e-commerce platform. So in our foreign data wrapper template, let's open up source, and in lib.rs, we can see some incredibly intimidating Rust code. But don't worry, you don't need to be a Rust expert to get this working. There are just three functions we need to modify, and that's our init function here, which gets some options from the request and sets up the base URL for requests to our Google Sheets API, which we'll modify soon. We then have the begin scan function, which actually makes that request to the Google Sheets API. And then we have a iter scan function, which runs for each row of the spreadsheet, transforming the JSON response that we get from Google into a Postgres result set or collection of rows that we can combine with other rows from our database. And don't worry, the documentation steps through exactly what we need to change here. So under developing a WASM wrapper, if we open up the advanced guide and scroll down to the code for our init function, so we can copy this one and replace our init function in VS Code. So that's this one. And we also want that begin scan function, which we can replace in our template. And lastly, our iter scan function, which we can replace here. And now we can close that one and forget we ever saw it. Now to deploy our changes to this template to GitHub, we can run git add and add all of those changes and then commit those changes with the message implement foreign data wrapper for Google Sheets. And then we can push to origin main. And then we want to create a release, which will bundle everything we need into a single file that we can access from our Postgres database. So we can say git tag to tag our current commit as version 0.1.0, and then we can push to origin version 0.1.0, which has created a new tag. So now if we go over to GitHub and find our repository, so this was our Postgres Wasm FDW repo, and if we go over to actions and enable those actions so it can run this workflow, and then let's create another tag to trigger that workflow so we can open up our cargo.toml file and maybe update the version to 0.2.0 just to keep this in sync with our tags. And then let's add those changes again, commit those changes with a message add tag, and then push that commit to origin main, and then create our tag for version 0.2.0. And lastly, push to origin version 0.2.0. And now when we go back to GitHub, we'll see it's kicked off our workflow for add tag. And once that's finished, we can have a look at the results and scroll down to the create readme.txt and run cat to look at the contents, and scroll all the way down to this env section where we can see our package name, its version, and this checksum, all of which we're going to need to set up our foreign data wrapper in Postgres. So let's head over to the Supabase dashboard for our project. If you don't have one of those, head over to database.new to create a free Supabase account and a new project. But once you're up and running, head over to the SQL editor, and you'll see I've created some example tables for customers and orders, and just inserted some example data, which we'll use to join together with our Google Sheets data once we've implemented our foreign data wrapper. So let's implement our foreign data wrapper. So we're going to create a new query where we're going to create an extension or install the extension wrappers and give it access to the schema extensions. We then want to create our foreign data wrapper called Wasm wrapper, giving it a handler and a validator, and then create a server for our Google Sheets server using our foreign data wrapper that we declared above and giving it the options for our package URL. So that's our release on GitHub. You'll need to update the org name to be your organization or GitHub user, and the name of your repo or the version if yours is not 0.2.0, which also needs to be reflected in our FDW package version. And then this checksum we'll grab from our GitHub release shortly. Next, we want to create a new schema to keep all of our Google Sheets stuff contained, and then finally create our foreign table for sheets in the Google schema with our three columns listed, our SKU, our name, and our price, giving it the server of the Google Sheets server that we declared above and the options for our specific sheet ID, which we can get from Google Sheets now. So if we click the share button again and copy this link and then paste it underneath, our sheet ID is after this /d/ and before our /edit. So it's just this bit, which we can replace inside these quotes and then get rid of the rest of this URL. Next, we need that checksum, which we can get from the readme.txt for our GitHub release. So let's copy that one and paste it in here. And now we can run this big blob of SQL, and we see success, no rows returned, meaning we now have that foreign table that can be treated like any other table in our Postgres database. So we can select all of the columns from our Google.sheets table. And when we run this, this is making a live request to the Google Sheets API and getting back all of the data from our spreadsheet. So if the CEO was to add another product for 101223, which is a sick cap that costs $50, if we run our SQL statement to select all of our products again, we see that cap is now included in that result set. So if we wanted to join this together with the rest of the data in our database, we could select star from orders. So remember, that links one of our customers to the product that they've purchased. So if we want to left join on our Google Sheets data on our Google Sheets SKU, matching our orders SKU, and also left joining in our customers on the customer's ID, matching our orders.customer_ID. Now we could select just the orders ID and pull out the customer's name as customer and the Google Sheets name as our product. Now we can perform a much more helpful query, seeing the ID for each of our orders the customer they belong to, and the product that they ordered. So all of the data for our e-commerce platform is conveniently combined in this one place, even though part of that data lives in our database and part of it lives out on the internet in our CEO's database or Google Sheet. If you want to go deeper with foreign data wrappers, then check out this video right here. Thor sits down with our very technical CEO, Paul Copplestone, to talk through why we built foreign data wrappers into the Supabase platform and how he was thankfully convinced to build Supabase on top of Postgres rather than Google Sheets. If you just want to go a little bit deeper with Postgres, then check out this playlist. But until next time, keep building cool stuff.